Follow along as we fill in a basic treatments list. We will create several treatments in ARM, demonstrating how to enter treatment information, including formulation concentration and product rates. We introduce validation lists, including how to find items in the list and how to build a personal list. We start by opening the tutorial protocol, filling in treatments. Note the option to switch from your study list to the tutorial list of example files, found at the bottom of the study list editor. Next, open the treatments editor. This is essentially a spreadsheet to enter treatment information in a clear and consistent way. The first treatment will be the untreated check. To begin, click into the Type field in the first row of the table, then click the drop-down button to display a list of valid entries to choose from. Select CHK and click OK to define the type or category of treatment for this row. You can also press the F9 key to display the list of valid entries for a field, called a validation list. Double-clicking an item in the list is another way to make a selection. That's all the information needed for this first treatment, since no product is applied for the untreated check. To define the second treatment, in the next row, enter a 2 in the treatment number field. Note that this row is now a different color to visually separate different treatments. Our next treatment is a herbicide called Stomper Plus. Since we have not used this herbicide before, it is not in our treatment list. So simply type the name and we will add it to our list later. Next, we enter the formulation concentration for this product, 480 grams active ingredient per liter of formulated product. Type the letter G to skip down to the first item in the list, starting with this letter. The formulation type field is very important in ARM. This is used to determine whether a formulated product is a liquid or dry formulation, which is necessary to ensure product amount calculations are accurate. The list of available product rate units are also determined by the formulation type. Next is the rate, the amount or dosage to apply to a standard area. For this example, enter 3 kilograms active ingredient per hectare. Note that this is not the amount of product for your plot size. ARM calculates that for us on the spray seeding plan report. The other rate provides a different view of the same rate or dosage information. ARM calculates the other rate when a unit is chosen in the other rate unit field. This can be useful to view both an AI-based and a product-based dosage, or view the rate in metric and US standard. After filling out a treatment line, we can add the product to our own personal validation list for future use. Click back to the treatment name field and display the list. Select yes to add this product to the list. You can also enter ingredient information for this product, if applicable. Now we can use the same product in the third treatment, just applying at a different rate. Select the herbicide type again, and now we see our Stomper Plus in the list as I start typing its name. Select the product to fill in its name and formulation information saved in the list. To duplicate the value from the cell directly above, type the single quote character and press enter. The fourth treatment in this study is a different product called Superstomp, applied with an adjuvant as well. First, fill in the Superstomp information on a new line, just like the previous lines. For large lists, press Add to Personal to create your own favorites list of your most common choices, so you do not need to search the entire list each time. On the next line, enter the same treatment number 4. This adds a second component to treatment 4. Each treatment in the study could have multiple components. Whether it is another product or adjuvant being applied, or to document an application technique or cultural practice that is being studied. Now fill in the rest of the treatment line with the NIS adjuvant, with a rate of 0.5% volume to volume.